Key Dominique, and I'm rocking out with Chi-Town.
Hey guys, this is Attila, ATTXLA, because X marks the spot all day, every day. And you are watching or listening to, depending on what you're doing, Chi-Town Urban Radio. Thank you.
Chi-Town Urban Radio.
Yeah, that's right. You just locked into one of the hottest shows in the Midwest. This is Chi-Town Urban Radio, baby, where we play the hottest music and discuss the hottest topics.
If I have an opinion about something, why should I have to say I'm sorry about it if that's my true opinion?
Right, exactly. So, because you don't agree. We agree to disagree.
Nobody does.
Yo, you never know what's going to happen next. So log on to ChiTownUrbanRadio.com. And make sure you follow us on Instagram at Chi-Town Urban Radio. Go ahead and hit us up on that call-in number, 312-985-7834. You got all that? Now let's go ahead and bring in our hosts. Chi-Town Urban Radio, please welcome Ebony, Kiara, and DJ Malone. They ready, baby? Let's go.
I'm all the way up. Nothing can stop me. I'm all the way up.
Turn myself up real quick. Hold on. What's going on? Yo, it's the one and only DJ Malone, man. I welcome you to another episode of... We'll get that situated. I welcome you to another episode of Chi-Town Urban Radio, man. Let me turn myself down. We're getting all haywire right now, but it's all good, though. Now, Ebony Care is on her way. She's, you know, my co-host. You know, she's always late. You know, females are always late sometimes. It's you know, it is what it is. But we do got two very special guests into the building. Now, I know you guys have been seeing. I've been promoting them, and they're here right now. Go introduce yourself as right now if you can.
What's going on, Chicago? This is RockStar.
Yo, this is the girl, Valon.
What's up? How y'all feeling?
Playing it all, man. I like to thank DJ Malone, man, for having me on this set today.
Yes,
oh, man.
To discuss a lot of stuff, man. We got a lot of stuff we want to talk about, man.
Oh yeah, man. You were telling me, man, that you had a lot of stuff to get off your chest, man.
Yeah, man. First thing I want to say is free Lil Jay, man. Yeah,
definitely.
Free Lil Jay. You know, he needs to definitely, you know, see the sunlight, man, and get his career revamped. He definitely does, man. We have a lot of material. We definitely want to drop this song. Lil Jay featuring P. Rico Squad Gang. We definitely gonna let the airways hit that for a little bit. Make sure y'all go copy that on iTunes.
Real. Is there any word on, you know, when he gonna get out, or, you know, how is he doing right now, man?
Man, right now, man, his trial starting in May.
Okay.
You know, so he's been incarcerated for a little bit over 2 years.
Okay.
And you know, his bond was initially $1,250,000. Yeah, so fortunately they dropped the murder charge, and right now he's just facing a reckless firearm. That's it. And his bond is set at $800,000, so $80,000. That's still a lot of money. So he's hit trial in May.
Okay.
And you know, we know what we're working against, so you know, everything's in God's hands.
Okay, definitely, man. Definitely. Now, you got your artist right here. Go ahead and tell the people who you is.
You guys, my name is Valon. I'm an indie artist from Chicago, born and raised.
Definitely.
Shout out the South Side.
South Side?
Yeah, so I definitely am on the uprise with my music right now.
Okay.
My genre is definitely R&B, a little bit of neo-soul.
Okay.
Me and Lil Jay actually have a few tracks together, quite a few.
Dope.
You can find me on Unexpected Fame 2. And I have a lot of stuff and a lot of projects that I'm working on right now.
Okay.
definitely would love to get my name out there. So
what part of the South Side from? Where you from?
From Morgan Park, baby.
Ooh.
Wild Hunters, Jungle, where you been?
Oh, man. I used to live in the Hunters back when.
You did?
I lived on 115th and Perry.
Get out of here. Yeah, I grew up on 112th and Church Street.
Woo!
Shout out MP Jungle.
Hey, y'all.
Come on, man.
Hey, now I'm over there by 79th and College, so I'm trying to get out.
I definitely hear you. So, just like the movie, right? Run
yeah.
fast.
Yeah, definitely. So how did y'all come together? How did you go about finding her and, you know, y'all coming together as a group?
Well, you know what? Initially, me and Valon, we was actually not doing no music. This is back in, like, 2005, 2006.
And okay.
It was more of a relationship thing. And then I gradually told her about, you know, how, you know, I'm interested in music, I do music. And it really took off for us, and it became very serious. We started off selling CDs in the street.
Mm.
You know, we used to, I was unemployed at the moment, she was unemployed, you know, and we had albums, and we pushed them out in the street.
Okay.
You know, and it gradually, you know, made it a good enough money, and, you know, got an additional job. That's when I met Monty.
Real.
You know, and met Monty, he was shooting my videos. And he shot a couple of videos for her as well.
Real.
We gradually invested in the studio.
Mm.
So, you know, we came a long way from where we at right now. And now, you know, she has an album working. She has two albums working. We have another project we're working on. It's a joint venture with Kevin. He's a guy, another guy from Chicago. We just left his studio yesterday.
Shout out Kevin.
Mm. Yeah, shout out Kevin.
Gift.
And, you know, we really, you know, this is what we do.
Real.
And we're definitely going to, you know, give it all we got because this is our year.
Okay, that's what it is, man.
Go ahead.
No, this is your time, baby.
Okay. Well, yeah, basically what he was saying, like, we've been knowing each other for a while, and kind of he introduced me to a lot of things, you know, about the music industry and whatnot. But a little bit for myself, I've been singing my whole life.
Real.
And I've actually been to American Idol, The Voice. I've been to
So you met Simon.
No, I ain't meet Simon. It's a lot to that they don't tell you. But other than that, I definitely have a passion for music. I've been doing this a while. I love to write songs.
Real.
You know, and I'm definitely looking to be that next R&B diva from Chicago.
What do you think R&B is right now? Like the state of R&B?
You know what? I feel like over the past few years, R&B has gotten a little bit better because in this era right now, everybody is kind of like into the whole 90s vibe thing.
Real.
Like, I like my girl 7th Streeter. I like Janae Aiko. I like Jasmine Sullivan. I love Lauryn Hill. I love 90s music, period.
Real.
So right now, like this little era that they got going on with the whole 90s vibe, I'm totally feeling it.
Real.
Because it definitely makes me, you know, puts me in a tune of R&B, you know, SWV, old school, Destiny's Child, all about that, you know.
Okay.
That's what we're trying to bring back, that whole sound. And you're going to definitely love my music, too.
Oh, yeah.
Absolutely.
I'm excited to hear this, man. Okay. The call-in number is 312-985-7834. Make sure you tell your pastors, your sisters, your brothers. Well, I don't know what you want to tell your pastors, but tell them anyway. Just tell them to call in.
What is it right now? I'm going to tell everybody to call. Hey, call this number right now if y'all got some questions.
Yeah. Call-in number if you got some questions. The number to call in is 312-985-7834. So that's the number to call in. Make sure you do it. Like I said, tell everybody, man. Man, we got the Rockstar movement into the building, man.
That's
and it's really a pleasure to have you guys, man. So let me ask you this before we go into the break real quick.
Okay.
As far as music, are you working to manage more artists, or are you just I'm cool right now?
You know what's going on right now is, man, I got a project going on myself too, you know, but it really started off me as an artist, and what got me into management is because I was going to sign an independent deal with, I forgot the label name, it was in 2011,
okay.
And that's when I met Dirk, Louis, stuff like that, because the label that I was going to sign to was recording in the same studio they was recording with.
Mm.
So the reason would turn me off for being managed or being signed to an independent label because their artist wasn't living a lifestyle like me.
Real,
you know,
real.
I was before the studio that I was recording in was $100 an hour studio.
Real.
So, you know, I was paying, you know, X amount of dollars And the engineer is like, hey, man, you got talent. I want to have you meet these guys.
Real.
So, you know, when I seen his artists and they wasn't really, you know, making the type of dollars I was making, I said, you know what? I can do what they're doing. Real, I don't have real. To. I don't have to just sign over my rights, or I can just, you know, invest in myself. And that was before I owned my studio.
Real.
So
real.
You know, once I did that and seen, you know, how the game worked a little bit, and then when I met Lil Jay, you know, which is my cousin, you know, in a sense, he lacked management. He lacked that, and he didn't trust a lot of people. It's some people that wanted to manage him, and he seen me like, you know what? This is my cousin. He has a degree. He's smart. He owns a studio. You know, I'd rather, you know, work through him. And that's what happened. You know, I just, you know, book shows for him, and, you know, just, you know, been his brains for him. Because, you know, they're young, they wild, and they out here, you know. They want to do them.
That's real, though. But see, the thing, the crazy part about it is, though, man, and I tell people this all the time, artists could be a banging, could have, like, a good joint, and he doesn't understand how to market himself. And as a manager, if you can't manage yourself as a manager, notice how I say this, you can't manage yourself as a manager, bring nobody else on.
Absolutely.
Can I say something in addition to that? Go ahead. It is hard trying to manage yourself as an artist. You will find yourself so clueless. You know, like, let's say you got a vision in your head, you know, to make it to the top and, you know, make millions of dollars and da, da, da. It's not easy. To even start from the bottom is not easy.
Real.
You know, so I definitely can relate to that. When I first started out, I was so passionate about it, but I didn't know where to, you know, start, and I just kind of started reaching out to different things.
Okay. Well, this is what we're going to do, man. We're going to come right back, man, and I'm going to go into the mix. My hands get a little fidgety when I...
Do your thing, DJ Malone.
Do your thing, DJ Malone.
We're going to come right back, man. We got the Rockstar moving into the building. 312-985-7834 is the number to call in. You can also tune in at that Q4.org or go to ShyTownUrbanRadio.com. Like I said, tell everybody, man, we're having a good time here. It's the one and only DJ Malone. It's 12:16. I'm kind of hungry. Hey, we're back into the movement, though. Hey, we're going to come right back. ShyTown Urban Radio, let go. Chi-Town Urban Radio, the best place to be at on any day. Really, it's the one and only DJ Malone. Hey, man, we still got my people into the building, man. How y'all feeling, man? How you feeling?
I can't complain, man. I can't complain. We feeling good.
Valon, how you doing, Valon? How you feeling?
How are you?
I'm doing okay, man. I'm kind of hungry, but it's okay, though,
me
man.
Me too.
They're calling number, and they're already calling in. I don't even got to say it. They're already calling
they
in.
Calling in.
Let's get the caller right here.
Hey, man, shout out to Florida. This Florida in the house, man.
Florida, what up? I can't hear you, bro. Your phone breaking up. We can't hear you, bro. Call back in when you got a better connection. Let's get this other caller. Caller, man, state your name, where you calling from.
Hold on.
Y'all be having some. All right. Say it again one more time.
All across the world.
What's going on? How you feeling?
Good.
Talk to us, man. Anything you want to say?
Tell them I hacked Ali Capone and I DM'd one of y'all.
All right, cool. I got you, bro. Free Lil Jay, man, right? Free Lil Jay.
Yeah, Free Lil Jay, yeah. I texted him on the thing, whoever had his account.
Real, okay.
Well, I got you, bro.
Free Lil Jay, that's what it is. Let's get this other caller. Thank you for calling in. Caller, man, state your name, where you calling from.
Hey, man, I'm calling from California, man. Free Double O. Hey.
What's going
Shout
on?
Free Lil
War, man.
Free Lil Jay, man. Free Lil Jay, what's going on?
Free Lil Jay, man. Free the Cloud War. Free Lil Jay, man. We miss you. We miss you back out these streets, man. Sorry, actually. Let's get
it. Love.
Let's get it. Let's get it. Anything else you want to say, bro? You want to say anything to your stalkers, your lovers, your supporters?
Man, sure. We miss him, man. Ain't nobody do it better than what
he miss y'all, man. Too, man. He definitely misses his fans.
Man. Make sure you DM, man, and I'll make sure you get a follow back, bro. Make sure you DM, man, because I run this account.
All right, man. Appreciate it.
Let's get this other caller. Overwhelming caller. Caller, man. State your name. Where you calling from?
This is Money. I'm calling from Toronto. Shout out Lil Jay.
Wow.
Toronto. Hey, Toronto. Canada. Canada so, State. Man, that makes me say,
oh, my God.
Shout out yeah. Canada.
What's going on, man?
Shout out Lil Jay.
He listens online. Hey, I appreciate you calling in, Jay. Let's get this other caller, man. Caller, man. State your name. Where you calling from?
Hey, man. Hey, man. Free Lil Jay, man. You know, man. Hey. Shout out, boy. Go check out my music video, though.
What's your name?
Shout it out, man. What's shout on? It out.
It's on YouTube.
Okay, what's your name, bro?
Hey. It's called Money Drop, though. Money Drop official video, man. Y'all know what to play. Go check that out, though.
I got you, bro. Much love, man. I appreciate you.
P.O.P. All the time.
That's what it is, man.
That's dope.
How does that make you feel that even though he's not physically here, but he is still here in the presence? How does that make you feel, bro?
Man, you know what? It's amazing, man. And I knew this day was coming, man. I'm telling you, it's been days where we had a meeting with, like, you know, an executive. And, you know, I always knew he had this potential. I already knew his value, man. And real. I just wish he could just see this right now, man. This is all independent, you know what I mean? Just to get these calls yeah. all across the world, man.
It's amazing.
It really is,
such
man.
Such an impact of his own.
You know.
Whatever type of music he into, look at how many millions of teenage kids
real.
Or older, you know, the youth is definitely into him.
Real. Let's get this other caller, man. Caller, man. Say your name, where you calling from. Caller, you there?
Hello?
Yes, I'm here, caller.
Yo,
you here?
Yeah.
What's going on?
What's going on?
Call back in when you got Metro. Caller, man, state your name, where you calling from. Do something. What's going on? What's going on with you? I can't hear you.
I'm from Jersey.
What's going on?
In the house.
Good.
Talk to us, man. Anything about Lil Jay, man? Free Lil Jay. What's going on?
Free that nigga, man. Free the nigga, man.
Hey, hold on. You can't cut, bro. You can't cut.
Yo.
I appreciate the love, though, G. Let's get this other caller, man. Caller, man. State your name, where you calling from.
Hello?
Yes, caller. We hear you.
Hello, can y'all hear me?
Yes.
Yes, we
yeah,
can
bro,
hear
we
you.
Hear you, bro. We hear you, bro.
Go on
well, I see the same thing on live, man. Where my man's at on live with the headphones.
What's up? It's Rockstar. What's going on, man?
Dude hung up. You must have really made him mad.
What's up, bro? Ask a question, man. Call back. Call back.
Hey, caller, man. State your name, where you calling from.
I'm Joshua, calling from Chicago.
Chicago!
What side you from?
East side.
Okay,
where over east you at, man? Where over east you at?
South Shore.
Okay, that's what it is.
Much man. Love to our own people.
Anything you want to say about Lil Jay? Anything? Any shout-outs?
You just want to say, Lil Jay like that. You see that again, man.
Okay, cool.
There you go, gang, man. I appreciate that, guy.
Gang and squad. Gang and squad,
man.
Caller, man, you on the line, man. State your name, where you calling from.
Yo, what's good?
What's up?
This is Dalton from Lynn, Massachusetts.
Massachusetts! Hey,
that's what's up, man.
Yeah. Oh, my God!
What's going on?
Yeah, you already know, man. I'm just calling, you know, say two little Jay and shit. Yeah, I already know that's my nigga right there.
Hey, I know y'all some hood guys, but you can't be cussing.
My bad, bro. My bad.
Definitely, man. Well, yeah. Anything you want to say about Lil Jay or any? If you know, he's gonna listen.
Nah, I mean, like people just need to keep putting money on the books and everything. You know, he needs to keep his head up. Everything.
Absolutely.
You know, keep doing what he needs to do. That's it.
Facts.
Okay, definitely, man. I appreciate you calling in.
Yeah, man. Take it easy.
Damn, man. They loving Lil Jay, man.
Hey,
and you know,
you.
We got to show him this, man. That's why I'm recording this, man. We got to show him
yeah.
the
so
love that he's getting.
Him.
We're going to take one more caller because I don't want to be that to interview just the callers. Caller, man, state your name, where you calling from.
Hello? Hey, man, it's Waldo from the South Side, man.
South Side, what up?
Oh, my God. Hey, man. I personally know Jay, man, and Chicago just ain't been the same music-wise since he ain't been with us, man. You, like, you don't see no shit titled FBG. It's just not the same, man, you know?
Yeah. Real. Okay.
It ain't got the same sound, bro, and I miss that shit, you know? So
hey.
I'm working on beats for him, bro. I might have a whole tape for him by the time you get out.
Okay.
What's your Instagram, bro, so we can follow you?
Waldo Soprano, no spaces, no nothing, just Waldo Soprano.
Bet it up. Thanks for your support.
All right, DM, bro, DM.
Yep, yep.
Okay, we're gonna take a break real quick. We're gonna take a break from the caller because we wanna focus on the people who got it. We're gonna take your calls in just a second, people. Let's get into this joint real quick, man. The Lil Jay joint.
Oh yeah,
talk to us about this.
All right, look, we're gonna take a like DJ Malone say, man. We'll take a hold on the callers, man. But make sure y'all call back, man, because y'all sure bugging me right now.
Cool.
But check this out, man.
Too.
This song, Lil Jay and P Rico called Squad Game, man. This song has been out for a little bit less than a year on iTunes. We published the album, but we haven't had no type of promotion on it yet until we got the account back and we're doing the full work. But this song is by P. Rico. Oh yeah, just got out of jail less than a couple months ago too. So you know, I know he glad he touched the ground right now. But this song, man, this is a real powerful song, man. This song is super gangster. I'm telling you right now.
Okay, definitely, man. What we're going to do, we're going to come right back, man. Hey, man, the call-in number, when we do call back, is 312-985-7834. Please, guys, no cussing. Just make sure, you know, I understand everybody's excited, Lil Jay and everything else like that. Any shout-outs you guys want to give out?
Oh, my gosh. You go first.
No, you go first. You go ahead.
Man, shout-out to Southside. Shout-out to my family, my friends. You just kind of caught me off guard. Shout out to Kev, the producer. Shout out to anybody who ever did tracks with me. Anybody in the Chicago area that ever did a track with Valon, shout out to you, okay? Because I have so many. Man, Dion, Jimmy Maxson, shout out to you guys. Appreciate everything that you guys taught me. Man, just to name a few, Vinny, good rapper, shout out Vinny.
Real.
So many.
Definitely.
Shout out Ed. You know who you are.
Okay, definitely, man. Anything you want to
follow my IG at Who Is Valon? That's VALON.
Okay, definitely, man. You guys want to introduce the track, bro?
Yeah, man. Right now we finna play this song for y'all. P Rico, Lil Jay, Squad Gang,
Gang,
Squad Gang, Free Cloud Lord, Free Cloud Lord. Let's get it.
Let's go. Gang. Yo, it's the one and only DJ Malone, Chi-Town Urban Radio, the best place to be at on any day. Really, it's the one and only DJ Malone. We still got my people into the building, man. Valon, I don't want to, how do you pronounce that name again? How do you pronounce, I don't want to mess it up, bro.
It's pronounced Valon.
Valon.
It's an Albanian name.
Okay.
Growing up, I hated it because all my teachers would be like, Valon.
Valon. Were they white?
Yeah, they were white folks. They were white folks. Or you get your substitute teachers that can't pronounce it at all. But I definitely grew into my name and decided to make it my artist name because I felt like it was unique.
Okay, definitely. So as a songwriter, how do you get into that moment? How do you get into where I have to write this song? Is it something that you're feeling?
Absolutely.
Okay.
As a songwriter, I'm either feeling it or 9 times out of 10, it's just something I'm going through at the moment.
Real.
If I'm going through something, I write my songs. If something bad has happened to me, something good has happened to me. But from an emotional standpoint, everybody has a journey to their life. I've definitely been through a journey in life.
And real.
A lot of my songs have just came from my journey in life.
Real. Would you find it being therapeutic?
Absolutely.
Okay.
I wouldn't say music is something I grew to love. I've always loved music.
Real.
And it's always been therapeutic to me. I love to go to the studio versus going out to the club with my girls, which I do.
Real.
But if I have an opportunity to go to the studio, I would choose that over going out.
Real. Who was some of your inspirations growing up, man? Who did you listen to?
Oh my
to?
Gosh. Listening. Growing up, believe it or not, I listened to Mariah Carey when I was a child. Lauryn Hill.
Okay.
Jasmine Sullivan when she came out.
Okay.
But honest to God, just Mariah Carey and Lauryn Hill and Beyonce was all I listened to when I was a kid.
Okay.
And I actually do like 365. What's that lady name?
Lord have Queen mercy. Latifah.
No.
She sounded like Queen Latifah for a second. I don't know.
I can't think of her name either, but she got a lot of good hits.
Okay, we'll figure it out.
No, not Tina Turner. She had a bunch of hits.
Lauryn Hill, Jill Scott.
365 days. The girl, the lady that made the song about the 365.
I don't know nothing about that.
Patti LaBelle?
Nope, close to it though. Lady with the short haircut.
I don't know.
Man, your mama listened to her, man.
I guess I got all the cuts. I gotta ask my moms then. I gotta ask.
Y'all don't know who it is?
I really don't. We'll look it up, man. Because there's something going on here. Cause I don't know what it is, but we're gonna figure it out.
Yeah, 365.
Put me in the mind of Selena Johnson.
I like Selena Johnson, but it's not Selena Johnson. She's an old school. Oh, wow. Thank you. So, anybody from the industry is definitely a compliment. Absolutely.
Okay. So how do you balance your personal life with your business? How do you balance that out?
You know what? That comes with growth. I do work. We all work. We all have bills, but we all find time for something that we are passionate about. We all find time for something that we want to do, and I find time for this every week, every day, every other day. Because not want something and not work hard for it. I can't not want be a singer and not go hard for it. You know what I mean? Like when Harry J was telling you, like, we sold CDs. I personally hated going out talking to other people like, hey, yeah, you want to buy my CD? You know, you just hate that feeling where you got to approach a stranger. But that grew with me in time as well. I definitely make time for music, and it's something I love to do. I wish I had more time to do it.
Harry, you're managing her and stuff like that. Is there been times where it's like, yo, we got to do this. We got to get up. We got to go. Man. Come on.
Man, it's been times with her and Lil Jay. I had to just tell them, this is, you know, if you really want something, then, you know, it's a true sacrifice. Yeah. You know, because we live in a huge city, man. There's thousands of rappers, you know, millions of rappers across the nation that want to be in your position, you know. And you got to just thank God that you're able to have time and have a luxury to even, you know, do this music stuff.
Real.
You know what I'm saying? Like that's just a luxury in itself, because a lot of people, you know, don't have that type of luxury. A lot of people take care of their parents.
Real.
You know, like, be honest with you. A lot of people, I know some guys that wish they did go out of town or whatever, but their mom's sick, you know, and their bills is behind.
Real.
It's like, you know, or they got multiple kids. You know, I have a daughter.
Real. So, okay.
Yeah.
Well, I think in, what's the word I'm looking for? In the music world, it's like, it can make or break you. Like, you know, my whole thing is that back when I drove from Chicago to New York just for a handshake. Mm-hmm. And it's dedication. Absolutely. It's like, I'm tired as hell, but I'll work till about 3 or 4 o'clock in the morning because I really want it. You know what I'm saying? To go on what you were saying, if you really want something, you're going to go out there and make it happen. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, it was like, you know, like literally, when I was at the Southern Cities, man, it was probably one of the most memorable, best experiences of my life. I tell people this all the time, man, because, you know, I was making, because at the time, you know, I had offered a fast food job.
Real.
I was working at Burger King on 72nd Stony Island.
Okay.
By the Moinoinks. And I was, you know, getting kind of pissed. You know, I wasn't pissed because I was working. I was getting 40 hours. But, you know, if you add up the math, I was really making roughly a little bit under $50 a day.
Real.
You know, an 8-hour shift to you know, send out these hamburgers. And I met it. You know, shout out to 747. You know, I met these guys, man. Shout that was
747.
I met these guys that was selling CDs, man. And I told them, I said, I did music too. Brought them over my house. First time I met them, brought them over my house. And he was like, man, you know, you should sell your music. And at the time, you know, I wasn't even, you know, making a lot of money like that. I was making a dead-end job. And me going 6 months nonstop, dressing how I want to dress. Real. You know, doing what I want to do, having my own product, meeting people,
real.
You know, was a great experience, man. And I'm, you know, before I ever hit bottom, I would do that. You know,
real,
it's,
real.
You know, that's you know, I'm not saying, you know, selling drugs, but that's damn near better than, you know, selling drugs, man. You know,
real.
You send up you illegally, like you're buying one CD, and you can sell it for a dollar and still make a profit, man. And it was a great experience, man, to meet people. And to really, you know, invest your time in this. It was like a gambling time for fame. That's how it really was.
Real, real. Okay. Well, that's what, the Moon, no one cares in there anymore, man.
Yeah, they ain't even there no more.
The Dominic's on Jeffrey's not even there anymore.
It's changing.
Dominic's ain't here, period.
That's the crazy part, because I remember when I was, you know, when I was a shorty, man, you know, the Moon, Oink, Dominic's, what's that, The Zone. You know what I'm saying?
Yep.
You remember stuff like that, and now it's like they're taking it away.
Now you got Starbucks
taking
and
all
Amazon
the good Chicago news away, man.
Starbucks on 71st.
Right.
What the hell on Stony Island? What the hell is that doing over here?
Right, come on. We still got Italian Fiesta, though. We still got that Italian Fiesta. That's the best piece of the Chicago,
black
man,
folks
right
ain't
there.
Drinking that coffee over.
Now they're gonna take pizza away. Watch. They're gonna take pizza.
Let me tell you something. I know you said you was from the South Side. Growing up on the South Side, we had a chicken place called Pete's. You could get 3 wings and
yes.
fries for a dollar.
Hey.
For a dollar.
Hey, man, it's
good
not,
mouth
it's,
sauce.
It, you know what, though? I went to Houston, and I couldn't get mouth sauce for days. They didn't know what the hell I was talking about. I said, you got some mouth sauce here? What's that?
I experienced that.
You talking about barbecue?
Right.
No, I'm talking about mouth sauce.
Yeah.
It's like a little tang to it or whatever, but you can only get it in Chicago, man.
Yep, only get it in Chicago. So, I learned that the hard way when I went down south and I couldn't get Hot Crunchy Girls.
Another Chicago moment, too, man. Bring it back, you know, far as, you know, I remember Soldiers at War.
Yes.
Come on, man. Y'all remember Soldiers at War out there selling them CDs out there. What was that? South Chicago, Chicago,
yeah,
79 South Chicago.
Yeah, man.
I'm telling you, Soldier. I used to remember being in the back seat of the car and look at the guys passing out the CDs and the bean pies and stuff like
exactly.
that.
Exactly.
Yeah, man.
The only people I see selling bean pies are the guys on 79th and Stony.
Yep.
And those are the only two. I don't see anybody else. Mm-hmm. You know, Chicago's changing, man, and I don't know if that's for the good thing or for the bad thing.
We gotta save our city.
But I don't know. They're just taking everything, man. So, as Chicagoans, what do you guys feel about when you hear about a chance for rapper coming up from, you know, basically doing it underground? How does that guy make you feel?
I like Chance the Rapper, and I love what he's doing, you know, supporting Chicago public schools and everything like that. So I'm pro Chance.
Okay.
I'm pro Chance.
Okay.
I do feel like things other than CPS needs work.
Yes.
Needs help.
Yeah.
You know, these poverty neighborhoods are still poverty neighborhoods.
Yeah.
And the crime is still being committed.
Exactly.
What are we doing to help these poor neighborhoods besides giving them link assistance, a corner store up the street, over expensive items in the corner store?
Exactly.
You know, like, let's get some more stuff beneficial to our people.
Well, here's my thing, and this was, I got a lot of slack from this. My whole thing is, I believe we handicap ourselves in a sense.
Absolutely.
Because I think that we are our own worst enemy. I look at it as, if you were on food stamps in 2007, and now we're in 2017, and you're still on food stamps, and you have not yet made a difference to go get a job,
mm-hmm.
to go out there and make something happen, then if your stuff gets cut off, I don't feel like that's not the government's fault. You need to be doing what you need to be doing at the end of the day. So my whole thing is, I think we have to figure out, okay, as a community, what's going to work for us? And we have to stick to that. So,
because we, you know, everywhere, you know, we have abused government assistance, but we have to want to get it for ourselves.
Yes, exactly.
Link card is cool and all, but I mean, what about living, not living beyond your means, or just going out and getting something and working hard for it? And you know, it's a BITCH paying cash for Link. I understand that, but the government definitely helps out.
Man.
But we take advantage of it sometimes.
Hey, I'm gonna say this. You know, shout out to Chance the Rapper.
out Chance the Rapper.
Yeah, shout out to Chance the Rapper, what he's doing for the city, man. So what that brother's doing, man, with his situation, far as not being signed, is just amazing, man.
Yeah.
The only thing I want, if I'm Chance, I just want the radio. Give me the radio.
Yeah.
That's the only thing.
And then look, here goes another thing too. You know, we got ton of artists. We got who's popping on? We got Famous Dex. We got King Louie.
Yes.
We got, you know, a lot of Chicago artists, man. And, you know, we can have, you know, three or four a little more Chance, man. People put this beef stuff to the side, man, and you know, join together and make something happen for these stuff. Cause all these artists got potential, man.
Yes.
So all these artists got potential. And that's one thing that I'm definitely, you know, got Lil Jay on, man. When you get out, man, we're definitely gonna give back. That's the number one thing we gotta do, man.
Are y'all having a party for Lil Jay?
Oh yeah, yeah. It's definitely gonna be a party for Lil Jay, man. And it's gonna be at the Trump too. We're gonna make sure at the Trump, man.
Yeah.
Okay. Definitely. When you talk to him, you know what I'm saying? Like, and you know, you're doing, you know, you're basically his legs, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, yeah.
And you know, that goes a long way. That means that you really rock with him, man. Because there's a lot of people who say, once, hey, I've been locked up before. I've been locked up in Cook County. Mm-hmm. Ain't nobody seeing me. Nobody riding me, but as soon as I get out, a touchdown. Oh, what's up, G? No, it ain't what's up, G. And you know,
that's
I've been locked up. So my whole thing is salute to you, bro, because that takes a real dude to do that.
Yeah, and it's definitely bigger than this too, man. You know, I get threats. You know, I get, you know, sometimes I gotta watch, you know, my location. You know, but I just thank the Lord that, you know, I'm a private guy. Real. You know, because before, like, you know, when I had my studio with Monty, I had, you know, different artists. I had King Yella came in there, my studio before.
He was on here.
Being a Black came to my studio before. FBG Doug, a couple people came to my studio before, and I let some people from the neighborhood come see. But it's like, you know, everything happened for a reason, because I think if I was at that studio right now, like I had a location, because right now I don't have no location. You can't, it's hard to find me, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Of how I move. But if I had a location, 9 times out of 10, something that happened to, same thing that happened to Monty probably would have happened to me, you know, not saying
and,
that,
yeah,
but just saying that my location, who I'm affiliated with, and stuff like that.
It's just crazy though, man, how people just don't want to see you shine. Like, if you're doing something positive and you're doing something good for yourself, and then you're trying to bring somebody on, people don't want to see. They want to kick you off that ladder and say you ain't going nowhere, because they're not going anywhere.
Yeah, man, definitely. And you know what, man, it's it is what it is, man. You know, and these, like, free Bump J too. Bump J about to come home, man. I'm gonna say that too. Free Bump J, man.
Bump J.
I think when Bump J come home, man, we gonna see a whole lot together, man. And we need to stop throwing up these BD stuff, GD. We need to start throwing these C's up, man. Cause I remember back when Chicago was Coach Confident, all that. We throwing them C's up Chicago, man.
Bring the taste of Chicago, you know, back.
We gotta
too,
stop.
Man.
We gotta
y'all
stop.
Gotta know how to act.
We gotta stop dividing ourselves, man. Cause you know, it gets to the point that the same set is divided. You know what I'm saying?
And that's what kills me when GD and GD go against each other, and I'm like, hold on.
Y'all folks.
Yeah. Like that trips me out when I see stuff. Oh well, he GD from 79. So I'm
they
GD from
each other.
From, what the?
I see going
but
against.
But isn't the main motto is to one. Growth and development.
Growth and development.
That's isn't that the main motto?
Growth and development.
GD is turning with the BD to kill another GD.
Right. Oh yeah, they switching like that.
Dirty.
They switching what? Like that, man.
I'm like, yo, this stuff is crazy. And it's like there's no, because when I was a shorty, you had, you know, the bigger heads and, you know, the guys who made sure that situations were good. You know what I'm saying? If something went down, remember back in the day in the Ickies, if something went down, it doesn't even have to be the Ickies, but back in the day, a guy, something, if, you know, somebody would get into it and say, oh, well, tell the shorties, or you might want to leave out, you know what I'm saying, because something's about to pop off. Now, these young cats, they don't even care. They say, pop, pop, pop. Whoever's out there.
Oh, they get clout for it. They actually get praised for it. You actually be more popular for it. You know, it gets to the point they want to be known as the person that did it. It's like, you know, it's like, fuck it. Like, the shooter gets clout, get ranked.
What trips me out is that, why would you get recognized for something to do that, man? Like, you know what I'm saying? Like,
that's going against your freedom. That's, I'm telling you. Privacy and freedom is everything, man. That's everything that money came by, man. Privacy and freedom, man.
It's It's crazy though, man. It's just we're gonna get something's gonna happen though.
Another
man.
Thing too. Let's start out these Chicago name artists. They need to start touching down to these local radio stations. Mm. They really do. I'm gonna say that too. They need to start touching down the DJ Malone. You know, I'm talking about Chicago. Chicago radio. Yeah. Out there at 87. You know, it's a lot of stations like this that need to be touched down by people with record deals. Let's stop going to GCI 92.3. But you know what that's about. Everybody know that's politics.
Can I say something? This needs to be said.
Okay.
I'm not gonna say I'm disrespecting the radio. I think I speak for everybody when I say you get tired of hearing the same thing
over and over again.
I wish that they would play a more of a variety. You can guarantee you gonna hear I Got Money way before the you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like, and it's the same thing every day. I don't personally know how the whole radio industry thing goes, but it'd be nice for our city to play some old stuff. I mean, even from the Chicago artists that made it, we don't even really hear they track.
Well, see, the thing is,
I hear a little Bibby sometime, but
yeah.
But
here's my thing. It's a program director's game. That now, what I mean by that is the DJs, they're becoming more yes men. Because back when the DJ, when I was younger, you know, I'm going to play what I'm going to play regardlessly. But now it's like the program directors will come down on you and say, well, this is what I want to play. And if you don't play that, if you step outside that box, well, guess what? You really need this brand to make it more, you know, make yourself look more better or bigger or whatever. If you don't do that, guess what? You get out. See yourself out the door.
Yep.
Yes, man.
So,
yeah, yes,
you
man.
Know what I'm saying? Now the we got, man. Valon. Ooh, man. Now, I don't know the name of the song. It's the track that, you know, that the email that came through. I don't know the particular name of the song.
I don't even know what song he sent, so.
It's on two. The one that said
two.
So that's the one.
Okay.
Yep.
Do you know the name of it?
You know what, you guys?
Yeah. Valon. Yeah, it's the name of it is called Case.
Okay. Okay, definitely. Okay.
Case.
That's pineapples. Okay.
Pineapples.
Man, we're politicking hard in here, man. That's what I like, man. We politicking hard, man. It's the one and only DJ Malone, man. Sat down on the radio, man. We got Harry. Yo. Harry, man, and Valon, man. Yo. I like that.
Thank you.
That's, she got both, man.
So let me ask you this before I go into any other questions.
Okay.
Did you do choir?
Yes, I grew up in a church.
Okay, so what were you?
Alto.
Okay.
Soprano when I was younger, but mostly alto. My mama definitely, she was one of those people. Rest in peace to my mother, actually. She took us to every church service there was. I'm talking about Sunday school, YPWW.
Real.
I know Jesus.
Okay. Definitely.
But yeah, singing in a choir. I even did it in school. I did drama in school and stuff like that. But when I got in high school, I joined the choir, and it was much more advanced than being at church. And I learned different tones about myself through choir.
Okay. Truth be told, I was in the choir in middle school.
Really?
Nah. I was a bass.
I was so shy. I actually messed up one time in middle school, sixth grade.
Okay.
And I was singing the national anthem, and I messed up one of my notes. But everybody still clapped. But
yeah,
that was the first time I ever messed up in public.
How did you feel?
How did I feel?
Yeah.
Oh, my gosh. My pulse was just beating, you know, like my heart was beating.
Right.
I feel like every time I go perform or if I go sing in front of anybody, whether it's for a funeral, a wedding, which I've done numerous times, I still get butterflies and stuff. I still get scared a little bit. I just go out there and do it.
It's natural, you know what I'm saying? The song that we just heard, now you were blown. You were saying some stuff, man.
Thank you.
So what did that track mean to you?
You know what? That track was basically, which track did we just play? You said it was Case, right?
Yeah, it was Case.
How did it go? I was listening to the other tunes and I got thrown.
All I want is you.
Oh, that was, I'm so sorry.
You're
that
good.
Was actually a good, passionate track that a lot of times when I go to the studio, I do write music.
Okay.
But a lot of my creativity does come from me freestyling. When I freestyle and I go to the mic and I'm singing into the mic, I feel like what I'm writing about, whatever person that put me through that, real. I'm saying it into the mic as if this is the person that needs to hear how they made me feel.
Real.
So I know that sounds difficult, but the mic is basically like the person I need to speak my thoughts into.
Yeah.
So I write it down, but if something I miss in my brain, I say it into the mic with feeling to, you know, let people know how I really feel.
Okay.
But that was definitely a passionate track. And I hope others can relate to it.
Real, okay. Now, let me ask you this. With Harry, how do you like working with Harry?
I like working with Harry. I'll be honest, sometimes it is World War II sometimes, but he does make decisions for my best
interest.
My best interest.
And you know what, though? The best people that you're going to be with or kind of help you along with is the people you're going to argue with.
And he has definitely been there to make sure nobody ever walks over me or makes the bad decision. So, you know, I appreciate him being here. I've actually, before I met Harry, I was managed by other people, and when he seen how we were working and how they were working with me and how I was doing tracks for them, but I couldn't get none to take home. And he's like, Valon, why don't you just, you know, be free? You know, that's not how you work. And I had stopped working with a lot of people because of things that he opened up my eyes to. So I was appreciative of him being here for my music career and stuff.
Okay, that's what it is.
Yeah.
Now, I manage models.
Okay.
A lot of those models you see back there, I manage.
Oh, okay.
So one thing I will say, as a manager, I always put their best interest first. Yeah. So I always tell them, hey, I may act like your daddy sometimes, but I do it because I care and I don't want to see you get messed up, because this is a grimy game. It's a lot of grimy people out there who get over on you just because, you know, clout. You know, we just talked about this.
Talk about the clout.
The clout situation. That clout is, it's so crazy because people kill for that, man.
Absolutely.
Kill
for, yeah. Yes,
so,
they do.
Now, with the social media stuff, now, I don't want to make you tell me your age, but are you a 90s baby?
I'm a 90s baby.
Okay.
I don't mind telling my age.
Okay, okay.
I'm 25.
Okay, okay, cool. So, you kind of, you're right below me because I'm 28. So, you're coming in when we had sidekicks, flip phones.
Yes, sir.
The most that we probably had of the internet in high school was probably MySpace, Tag.
And we wasn't even on Facebook like that. Facebook was considered lame back in the day because then nobody really, when you get online, it wasn't appealing to the eye.
Yeah, exactly. Because remember, you could customize MySpace.
And
yeah,
if you were a real 90s baby, you had a Bebo page.
Bebo!
Oh, my God!
Bebo. You had a Bebo page.
So how do you feel about today's age? Because you've been on your phone. Not saying that's a bad thing, but you got Instagram, Facebook, Snapchat, Twitter.
Like the world does modernize as the days go by and the years go by. I feel like this generation has much more of a potential to get themselves out there, or whether it's just for you to have more followers, you have such an advantage. When we was coming up and going to school, we had computer class. When you go to computer class, you had your computer games. Nobody was really, even when we had MySpace and Bebo, it was like you wanted to meet people from other high schools or you know what I mean? This is a whole nother level. Like, y'all can go live and, you know, sometimes that can get out of hand. You know, like, it's super duper modernized. And I feel like they have such more of an advantage than we did.
Real, real.
You know what I'm saying? Even when flat screens and touch screens first came out. Like, if you look back when Verizon and all of them first came out, it wasn't even all that.
No.
You know what I mean? Like, Sidekicks was so cool. They still are so cool. I had a Sidekick too. I definitely miss it. But it, y'all have much more of a, you know, advantage in this generation right now.
Real.
Absolutely.
Harry, let me ask you this though, man. Like, I just think, what's the word I'm looking for? I think social media makes the tough guy Axel a tough guy. And he's not really a tough guy. So put it like this. You know how you were telling me people would just say any old stupid thing on Instagram or Facebook.
Absolutely.
And when I meet you in person, it's, oh, what's up? You ain't talking that tough Sony stuff that you were talking on Instagram. And my whole thing is that I think the downfall of it is, internet has made anybody can has an opinion. Mm-hmm. Sometimes it doesn't involve you. Just shut the hell up. That's all you got to do.
And it's the this is the generation of scheme, pyramid schemes. A lot of these people can go on here and make pages, and Facebook even allow you to, you know, like sell yourself and stuff like that, like fake brands, you know. So, man. Definitely.
Man, it's just, I don't know, man. This whole internet stuff is it cool, but then it's like it can have its downfall.
Yeah.
Yeah, you know what? Yeah, it just makes the shy guy be heard, because you know there's some people that you know that are not that vocal in reality, but are very vocal over the media stuff like that, man. But you know what? I take the good with the bad. What does that watch tell you? You got to take the crickets with the straight. That's what he say.
Exactly.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying? So,
take
you know,
the crickets with the straight.
You got to take the cricket with the straight, man. I just take it for what it is and try to, you know, make positive energy like that. But, yeah, it's all a facade. You know, it was guys talk stuff. Like, you know, it's like the guys talking stuff for the media is kind of like how before the media was popping. It's kind of like how it's like hearing from the grapevine when you say, oh, whatchamacallit, say whatchamacallit. Then when you go ask him, he don't know what you're talking about. So, you know, I feel like it always been there. The facade always been there. You know, it's just a newer version online. Okay. That's all it is. It always is there.
Okay. Well, that's what it is then, man. Who you listening to, man? Who you jamming to?
I'm a Kanye West, Jay-Z type guy.
Okay.
Lupe Fiasco, Kid Cudi, you know, I'm one of them type of
guys. So you're a lyricist?
Yeah, man. You know, I rap, you know, lyrics and, you know, And I don't downplay, you know, none of these guys making, you know, trap music or anything like that, because it's all about making good sound. You know, before it's like the music that you can play from 30 years ago, and you might play this now, and some of the people are like, oh, that's weak, that's whack. But, you know, in that time period, you know, it was good. It was good music, and I just feel like that, you know, it's just all about creating good sound. I can make a sound like right now. I can make a song. And it's all about probability too. You know, I can make a song right now, 30 seconds long, named Boo 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 Boo. I can say Boo 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 100 times. And I might let 100 people hear it. It might be one person out of that 100 people that might say, you know what, this is a cut.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? Yeah. So, you know, I just feel like it's all about how many ears you get a chance to expose to.
Real.
How many listeners you can expose to.
That's real though, man. You know I like saying? That. I like that. I like that analogy, man.
Yeah, yeah. Because, you know, that's what it's all about. That's why we're here now. We're here to get, you know, get more listeners.
Real. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? That's all what it's all about, man. And it's always, I don't know, I think it's not if you could be talented, but do you have a brand?
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? That's what it is now. Like, you know, and not saying that talent doesn't do anything, but now when a person like Welvin the Great, like these nuts guy, can go, and he got booked to go to Adriana's. Mm-hmm. I was tripping out. Like, they were broadcasting on the radio, Welvin the Great at Adriana's, mm-hmm, be there tonight. What? But he has a brand.
He has followers.
Is it more what kind of followers you got, and then you're in the door?
Yeah. You know, I think it's just all about attention. How much attention that you can that you can prove,
they got a way you could buy followers now too.
Yeah, that too. Yeah, they do. But just for example, I don't know if y'all seen on WorldStar. I think it was yesterday. It was a guy in a diaper. His name was DaBaby or something like that. I don't know if y'all seen that, man. It's a guy. It was on SXSW, the you know, the music event or whatever, and the guy had a diaper on, and he was walking around. People was taking pictures. He's an actual rapper and an actual grown up diaper, and he got a lot of press off that, man. So, you know, people fighting for attention. They dying for attention out here. That's what's going on, man. They dying for attention, man. Oh my god.
Well, that's the same thing with that Catch Me Outside, that outside girl.
Oh yeah, yeah.
And
I don't even know how she blew.
She blew off because she was on Dr. Phil before.
Okay.
And then I think after the show,
she got to do with somebody and talking about Catch Me Outside.
It was some stupid stuff, like,
oh wow, I didn't even know that.
Yeah. And it's, people will blow up on anything. You remember that cupcake video? It was like a video called Cupcake.
By who?
That's the artist's name. Cupcake. Oh, okay. Vagina.
What?
I gotta show you that.
Wow.
We me and my guy at Sci-Town, He shot it. I did the editing on the video. You have to see. It's ratchet as hell. I can't even play it on the radio. That's how ratchet it is.
Hold on. Are you talking about the... she's a girl, right?
Yeah.
And she's like a super freak. Mm-hmm. And she was doing some stuff in the video.
Yes.
And she's from out here, too.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Me and Shachan, we did the video.
Yeah, I know exactly who she is.
And she blew up, and that took... Anything will go now, man. Anything goes.
Yeah, and she's like that now. It's like that. She's still rolling off that. I know exactly what you're talking about. Because she did an interview on Say Cheese, I believe.
Yes.
Yep, yeah. That's the girl. Yeah. Mm-hmm. I forgot her name.
Okay.
Okay.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's crazy though, man.
Anything, her whole image is like free, like
anything goes.
Super free.
Everybody ain't willing to humiliate themselves. Some people do it and doing it for the cash. Everybody want to do it for the cash, but everybody don't want to do anything for the cash. Yeah. I don't think
anything's possible now, guys. Anything, it's the internet. Anything's possible.
Anything yep. goes. Anything.
What's
goes,
next? Man. Somebody gonna actually have an animal outfit on to start rapping. That's what's next. Somebody's gonna be a horse. Somebody gonna have
somebody
a horse mask and
horse,
just spin
by. Somebody had a horse mask and they went to the barn and stood in front of a real horse to see the horse's reaction.
Dumb. Yeah. Just being dumb.
Yeah, just dumb stuff.
Oh man. So let me ask you this. You feel like singing?
Sure.
You feel like, you know, doing like a little freestyle or whatever?
Sure. All right, you play something. Right. You gonna play something?
Yeah, I'm gonna play
absolutely.
Something.
Okay, oh
so you want a slow beat? You gonna be singing, right? You want a slow beat or something?
Yeah,
okay,
let me get
a slow tempo. Here we go. Matter of fact, can you do something off of this right here?
Yeah, cut it up.
I'm gonna give you a challenge though.
Okay.
A challenge. So what you're gonna do is you're gonna rap about, of course you.
I'm listening.
Of course you. And of course me, DJ Malone.
Okay.
And Chi-Town Urban Radio. Can you
okay.
do that?
Chi-Town Urban Radio.
Yeah.
Yo, yo, DJ Malone up at Chi-Town Urban Radio. Ooh. Who you knowin' now?
Sing it, baby.
Dropping hits after hits. Right here in Chicago, right here in Chicago. And now you know my name. Said it called me for the line. And it's Albanian.
Well,
even though I'm African, American.
Okay.
Who you know now? Cause here I am to make my mark. Chicago Urban Radio. Okay, that's all I got.
Hey, that's what it is,
yeah,
man.
Good job.
Hey, that's what it is, man. I like that. That's
you.
Oh, she got more. Oh. I thought she was coming back.
So you thought I was coming back now.
Okay, hold on. Let's get this caller. Huh? Caller, man. Say your name, where you're calling from.
Rochester, New York.
What's going on, Rochester? What's going on? How you feeling?
Free Lil Jay.
Free Lil Jay, that's what it is, man.
Let's get
that hashtag going. Free Lil Jay. Hashtag Free Lil Jay, man. Anything you want
to
say?
I could donate.
You said what, bro?
I could donate at.
Hey, man, you want to donate? You click the link in the bio. Go to Lil Jay's bio, Lil Jay 063. Click the link in the bio and donate.
Where at?
Lil Jay 063, Instagram. And click
Instagram.
Yep, and click the link in the bio. And then you can donate. If you have any problem, DM Rockstar Harry J. That's my personal.
Rockstar Harry?
Yep, Harry J. DM me. And I'll get you step by step, bro. I appreciate your call.
All right.
Appreciate you calling in. Oh, so now they're starting to call back again. They doing it again, man. Hey, call them, man. Say your name, where you calling from.
Hey, man. I'm from Harlem, man.
Yo, everybody eats, B. Everybody eats.
On that thing, bro.
Anything you want to say to about Lil J, bro?
Yeah, man. Free the God, man. Free my God. Tell him keep doing his thing in there, man. Tell him don't lose hope, man. Hope my God be home soon, man. For real.
Definitely. Okay. That's what it is, man. I appreciate you calling in.
You already know. Love is love. Straight from Harlem, man, to the Shy.
Sure.
Yo.
Harlem, stand up.
So cool.
Man, that's love, man. You can
that's what I'm saying.
All in the streets.
Hey, man, that's what
all
it is.
All in the streets, son.
Y'all want to go live again and see if we can get some more callers? Oh, hold
sure.
They're
going to call right now, bro.
Caller, man, state your name. Where you calling from?
Gabe De Niro, Dixon, Illinois.
I can't hear you. Say it one more time.
Gabe De Niro, Dixon, Illinois.
How you feeling,
Illinois.
Man?
Illinois.
Pretty good. I got a few questions.
Okay.
When is Lil Jay Dope Man dropping?
Hey, right now, man, I got a playlist. I got a playlist right now, man, in my email, and it's all about Lil Jay. It's all about what he wants me to drop. So I can't give you a time period, bro, but I can tell you that we got over 30 songs unreleased, over 30 songs, man, and everybody want to hear that song with him and Lil Pappy too. We got that going too, but I can't give you no time period, bro.
Okay, are we going to see Dear Mama's video drop?
Oh, yeah, man. That's definitely, you're definitely going to hear that. I think that should be like the first video, to be honest with you, man.
Yeah, it was a really good song. I really liked that a lot.
And where you calling from again?
Dixon, Illinois.
Okay, for sure, man. Yeah,
Shout out
Dixon, Illinois. Definitely DM, and I'm guess definitely give you a follow, boy. I appreciate the call, man.
Yeah, no problem. Thanks. Free Lil J, WTO.
Free Lil J, WTO. That's what it is, man. Let's get this other caller, man. Caller, man, state your name. Where you calling from?
Calling from St. Paul's, North Carolina.
Carolina, what up?
What up, man?
What's going on? What up, man? What up, man? Just wanted to shout out Rockstar Harry J, you know what I'm saying? That's Bro, you know what I'm saying? Shout out Lil J, you know what I'm saying? Free Lil J Double O, man. I was supposed to work with Bro before he got locked up. I used to stay in the Shy, now I'm back in the Carolinas.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying?
Okay, where'd you stay at in the Shy?
I stay at in North Carolina, Fayetteville, North Carolina, where I was born, but I live in St. Paul's.
Okay. Dope, man.
Hey, man, I appreciate the shout-out, bro. I really, this is Rockstar right now. I appreciate the shout-out, bro. DM some information, bro, and I'll make sure I follow you, bro, and we should stay in tune, man. Thanks for the love.
I got you, bro. I think I already tried to follow you. I think I tried to hit your inbox one time to get a little information on bro so I can write him again because I smacked his books one time before I left the Shy, but... You know what I'm saying? That's bro.
Bro, that's super gangster, man. Do it again, bro, and just put in the Urban Radio, bro, and I got you. For real.
Man, I got you, bro. I'll hit your inbox right now, matter of fact. Because I was just watching y'all live.
Hey, man, appreciate it, bro. Thanks for the love, man.
That's love, man. Appreciate you calling in, G.
All right, G.
Hashtag free little J. Tell your pastors, I want you to go to the mailman and tell them that. I want you to go to the guy down the street and tell them that. Tell them to call in and hashtag Lil J. Hold on, let's get this other caller, man. Caller, man, state your name. Where you calling from?
Hey, this is Donmere from Wilmington, Delaware. 302 all the way here.
Delaware, I see you.
That's what's up, man.
Yeah, we out here. We rock with 00 Heavy out here.
Oh, wow.
That's what it is.
What's up?
I appreciate that,
yeah.
Man.
I'm just calling to check up to see what's going down with my man, Lil J.
Alright, look, right now, bro, his trial starting in May. You know what I'm saying? And we got everything we need, bro, to make sure bro come home, man. Because you know they offered him that eight-year deal and he turned that down. So you know if bro turned down that 8-year deal and we don't have no public defender, that means we working with something, bro. And you got to keep this in mind, too. They never caught him with anything. They didn't catch him at the crime. They didn't catch him with no guns. They just went to his house and locked him up based off hearsay. So, cuz coming home, bro. Gang.
Gang. Just know we keep rocking out here with the 00.
Yep.
You're too heavy.
Okay. Thanks for the call, bro.
Thank you, man. Thank you for calling in.
No problem.
Call him, man. State your name. Where you calling from?
How y'all doing, man? This is Jay Smoke, man. I'm from Louisville, Kentucky. They call it Murderville, Kentucky now, man. It's just going down.
Kentucky.
Hey, Kentucky. With my chicken.
Kentucky fried
chicken. First off, I want to say free Double O, man. Free Lil J. Shout out to Rockstar, man. His cousin's really holding it down for him, man. Niggas is funny as hell.
Gang, but you can't cuss, bro. You can't cuss on that.
Okay, my bad. Okay, yeah, I know I'm on the radio. I'm going to say a couple things. Yeah, most definitely, man. And I'm supporting the whole Free Lil Jay movement, man. You can even see, man, he got Chief keeping them even riding these waves, man.
On that thing.
Free Lil Jay.